Grange Favorite for KLBMA. Just the ladies on the second verse, all the men on the third verse, Lia Lez. 65, a redshirt.
Sing number 65, He Planted Me Deep. This will be our last song.
65 songs in time. What number are we on?
65, He Planted Me Deep.
Thank you. now long reunited and were in the ring that my father gave me, planted so deeply and anchored so firmly and tied up so tightly with love holding me. But when Jesus found me, he rooted, he ground me, he planted me deep like a tall mountain tree. Stopped all my going and leaving forever. I'm bound by his love. I don't want to be free.
On the second stanza, it says here, keeping the distance while building my wall up and closing my mind to the family I knew. Have you ever done that? Have you ever kept your distance? Do you put walls up? Do you try to not get close to people? Do you try just to be by yourself, be your own person, and not participate in anything just because you want to be left alone and you want to do what you want to do? You ever felt like that? Do you still feel like that? Good. Some said no. If you still feel like that, I'm telling you, you're in the right place for that to stop. If you want to feel the love that we feel, then accept Jesus Christ as the Son of God. Become a member of this church and feel the love that we have for one another. Feel the love that when somebody's not doing well and you don't know what to do, you make a phone call either to a brother or sister of Christ or to one of the ministers, and we pray for you. If you go through a situation that you don't know how to get out of, you have people here, you have brothers and sisters in Christ that will talk to you and counsel you and help you. And really, what we will do is just listen. A lot of times, when we tell people our problems, we don't want them to tell us what to do. We just want them to listen. You want somebody to listen? We're right here. Ministry's here. Your brothers and sisters in Christ are here. And we're ready to listen. And why are we going to listen? Because when you get done telling us about your problem, we're going to do two things. We're going to tell you we love you, and we're going to go to God in prayer for your situation, no matter what. I'm not perfect, never have been, never will, but I will try my best as a servant of God to be there for you in your time of need. If there's a crisis in your life, if there's something that's bothering you, if there's a situation that you say, I can't get out of it, I know the solution, and that's God. He will take care of you. I love you. Who's sitting at the table today?
I am.
What song have you selected?
348, the same song.
Thank you.
all stand.
And dear Lord, we come before you this day, Lord, thanking you, Lord, for the times that we've trusted and obeyed, Lord, and you helped us through our situation, Lord. You helped us through whatever problem we're going through, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for the time that we ran up to you, Lord, and said, forgive us, and you forgave us, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for those moments, Lord, when things seemed impossible and didn't know how to get out of the situation. You were quick, Lord, to be able to provide a way, Lord. You were able to take care of us no matter what the situation is. All we have to do is trust and obey. We have to read your word, study your word, Lord, and become knowledgeable of what your word is trying to tell us. And when we do those things, when we do these things, Lord, about absorbing your word, Lord, it becomes easier and easier to trust and obey. We thank you, Lord, for all that you do. We're thankful, Lord, for those that are here today, Lord. And Lord, there's individuals that have been sick over the last couple of weeks. There's been individuals that have been dealing with different situations in their lives, Lord. There's been prayers that have been sent out, Lord, and we ask you, Lord, that you help all these individuals. Those who have received prayer, Lord, have been answered, Lord. For that, we thank you, Lord. We thank you for Brother Bill being here today, Lord. He didn't feel well this morning, Lord. I hope he feels better now, Lord. Being here in this church, Lord, in this building, Lord. He was anointed, and we thank you, Lord, for your ministry, Lord, that is able to anoint those that are not feeling well, Lord, those that are having need, Lord, that we're able to lay hands upon them, Lord. Being called by you, Lord, having authority of Jesus Christ to pray for those that are sick, to anoint those that are not feeling well, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for your church, Lord. We thank you for your son, Jesus Christ. Lord, be with my brother, Jerry, Lord, as he opens up the meeting, Lord, and brings the word, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for all that you do. We ask you all this in the name of your son, Jesus Christ, Lord. Amen.
I always like it when Brother Reuben asks me if I want him to go get Sister Mary. Like, I can somehow do it without her. that just isn't going to happen. Sister Mary has the distinct privilege of having job security.
Dice que tengo la seguridad de tener un trabajo. Is that good?
I don't know, is it?
I don't know what you're talking about. Bill, yo le pregunté que si es bueno porque no sé de qué trabajo está hablando.
I was trying to say in a very kind way how much I appreciate you.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And how much I value your assistance in my ministry.
Les pido perdón a mi hermano porque él me quería dejar saber que él está agradecido que puedo hacer esto para ayudarle a dar la palabra.
That's okay. You didn't know. Has anyone ever had a promise broken to them?
¿Alguien hoy ha tenido a alguien que le rompa una promesa?
Have you ever broke a promise?
¿Usted ha rompido una promesa?
I mean, it's something we're proud about. I'm not asking you to smile and say, yes, I broke a promise. Yeah.
No quiero que sea algo que tenga gusto decir, sí, yo quebré una promesa.
We count on promises as being the bond of our word.
Nosotros hacemos promesas que es algo que cumplimos con nuestra palabra.
You know, there used to be a time when your word was rock solid. Shaking hands was a legal binding agreement between two people.
Hubo un tiempo cuando la agarrarse de mano era como una cosa legal en que usted iba a cumplir con esa promesa.
Unfortunately, that's not true anymore.
Pero ahora eso no es verdad.
We now have become very legalistic. We have to have everything in writing, and we don't trust anybody because too many promises have been broken.
Y ahora en este día es todo queremos escrito contrato porque ya no podemos creer en nadie porque nos han quebrado muchas promesas.
Brother Mike, I'm going to start this morning in the book of 2 Peter. Chapter 3, verse 9.
Vamos a comenzar con la segunda de Pedro, chapter 9.
Chapter 3.
Capítulo 3, versículo 9.
And we're going to talk a little about promises.
Y vamos a hablar un poco de las promesas.
I guess that probably was no secret, huh?
Yo creo que eso no era, fue un secreto.
The apostle is writing to the Christian church, and he wants them to know that God not only makes promises, he keeps them.
Este apóstol está hablando a la iglesia cristiana y le está dejando saber que Dios hace promesas, pero que también las cumple.
And the promise he was speaking about specifically here is the second coming of his son.
Y la promesa específica que estaba hablando en este tiempo es la segunda venida de Cristo.
And it says, the Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance.
El Señor no tarda su promesa como algunos la tienen por tardanza, sino que es paciente para con nosotros, no queriendo que ninguno perezca, sino que todos procedan al arrepentimiento.
God has been making promises from the very beginning of time.
Dios ha estado haciendo promesas desde que el tiempo comenzó.
And he has been faithful to all the promises that he's made.
Y él ha sido fiel a todas las promesas que él ha hecho.
Now, a lot of times, these promises take different shapes.
Muchas veces, esas promesas son de diferentes tipos.
And the one I'm thinking about in particular today comes in the form of a blessing.
Y la, una promesa que ahorita estoy pensando es la, una promesa de bendición.
At the end of his life, Jacob called all of his sons together and said, I want to bless each and every one of you.
Jacob, cuando llegó al fin de su vida, llamó a todos sus hijos porque él quería darles una bendición a cada uno de ellos.
And each one, whether he was a good son or a bad son, got a blessing.
Y aunque los hijos fueron buenos o malos, él cada uno le dio una bendición.
And of course, the one we're most specifically concerned about is the blessing he gave his son Joseph.
Y nosotros estamos más definitivamente concentrados en la bendición que él le dio a José.
And of course, you know, Joseph had to be like the favorite son, right?
Y sabemos que José era el hijo favorito.
He didn't get just a blessing for himself. He got a blessing for his two sons as well.
Él nada más recibió una bendición para él, pero también recibió una bendición para cada uno de sus dos hijos.
And the blessing and the promise that he gave to Joseph is really the foundation of the Church of Jesus Christ.
Y la promesa que él le dio a José y a sus dos hijos es lo que está fundando la iglesia de nuestro Señor Jesucristo.
You know, if I could find it really fast, we'll read it.
Está buscando para poder leerlo.
It's Genesis 49.
Genesis 49.
Yes, thank you.
Genesis 49, versículo 22.
I wasn't planning on reading it, but it popped into my head, so thank you, Brother Mike.
No iba a leerlo, pero se me ocurrió y lo voy a leer.
He says to Joseph, you will be a fruitful bough, even a fruitful bough by a well, whose branches run over the wall. Sister Lily?
Ramo fructífero, José.
We believe that promise to be one that says, Joseph, your family is going to travel over the wall being the great ocean.
Nosotros creemos que en esta palabra, la promesa de José era que él iba a ir sobre la pared y el Apader representaba el océano.
Now, if you're going to go over the wall, you got to go somewhere.
Si vas a subir sobre el Apader, tienes que ir a una parte.
And what's over on the other side of the ocean from Israel?
Y que está al otro lado del mar de Israel.
Well, even the eighth grade geography people can tell you it's the United States.
Los que están en el octavo grado en la escuela saben que es los Estados Unidos.
So he's promising him right here, your family is going to come to this land.
Y aquí le está prometiendo que su familia va a venir a esta tierra.
And so we believe that prophecy had occurred.
Y nosotros creemos que esa profecía ya ocurrió.
As a matter of fact, it talks about this family in the Book of Mormon.
Y en esto es platicado de esta familia en el libro de Mormón.
And the Book of Mormon is just full of promises that God has made to his people.
Y el libro de Mormón está lleno de bendiciones que el Señor ha dado a esta gente.
God promises that he is going to raise up a people on this land to help gather all of Israel to a promised land.
Una de las promesas es que él va a recoger toda la gente del mundo a esta tierra para traerlos todos a la tierra de Israel.
God promises this family that no matter how much heartache and destruction occurs, there will always be a part of them to survive.
Y el Señor les ha prometido que aunque pasen muchos problemas, mucha destrucción, todo el tiempo va a haber una rama de esta gente.
He promised them that this land would be a promised land full of good things that help them grow and be strong in the earth.
Y el Señor les prometió que la familia que estuviera en esta tierra, Él les iba a ayudar a ser fuertes y tener buen fruto aquí.
He promised them that He would lead them here, no matter what it took.
Y Él les prometió que Él los iba a guiar aquí, no importaba qué tenía que pasar.
He even promised that there would be a person later on in their history who would be a great man, even unto Moses.
Y también les prometió que en esta tierra iba a traer a un hombre que les iba a ser mucho más grande que Moisés.
And he promised them that the record that he asked them to keep would be preserved forever.
Y él les prometió que ellos tenían que preservar la palabra que él había escrito para siempre.
And he promised that to anyone who kept his commandments, they would prosper in the land.
Y él les prometió que todos los que cumplían con sus mandamientos iban a prosperar en esta tierra.
And so today, I'm here to tell you that God not only makes promises, he keeps promises.
Y hoy les quiero decir que Dios no nada más hace promesas, pero las cumple.
He's made promises that were established thousands of years ago that are now beginning to come true.
Hizo muchas promesas hace millones de años atrás y ahora estamos viendo que se están revelando.
And he has been gradually building his promises and his faithfulness over the period of 1,000 years.
Y despacito hasta cumpliendo todas las promesas que él tiene para las cumplir sus promesas.
My mistake, thousands, multiple thousands of years.
Millones de millones de años.
And he's been laying a foundation that he expects all of us to build on.
Y él ha puesto un fondo para que todos nosotros podamos construir sobre ella.
Now, I want you to answer me a question.
Yo quiero que ustedes me den una respuesta a esta pregunta.
And if you don't agree with this question, that's okay.
Y si usted no está de acuerdo con esta pregunta, está bien.
Can God do anything?
¿Dios puede hacer cualquier cosa?
Can God keep his promises?
¿Dios puede cumplir sus promesas? Amen.
Can God keep promises that are thousands of years old?
¿Dios puede cumplir con las promesas que hizo miles de años atrás? Sí.
Can God keep a promise to you that only happens next week?
¿Él puede cumplir una promesa que le hizo a usted que se cumple la semana que entra?
Sí.
Sí.
Ah, we're a little less sure about that one, aren't we?
No estamos muy seguros de esa respuesta.
All of a sudden it got personal.
De repente se fue muy personal.
If God is going to be faithful for thousands of years for his people, and we are his people, won't God be faithful to us?
Si Dios ha sido fiel por todos estos miles de años y ha cumplido con sus promesas, y nosotros somos su gente, ¿ustedes no creen que va a cumplir su promesa a nosotros? Amén.
You know, when we stood at the water shore, we made two promises.
Cuando fuimos a las aguas del bautismo, hicimos dos promesas.
We promise, and all of us that were baptized have said the exact same two promises.
Y todos los que hemos sido bautizados hemos dicho estas dos promesas.
And if you get baptized in the future, you will say you will make the same two promises.
Y si usted se bautiza en el futuro, también va a hacer estas dos promesas.
Do you promise to repent of all of your sins that you've ever committed, anything that you did to violate God's law? Do you promise you'll never look at those again?
¿Prometes que cuando vas a arrepentirte de todos tus pecados, todo lo que has hecho en tu vida, y que vas a hacer el esfuerzo de no hacerlos otra vez?
And of course, we all said yes.
Y todos dijimos sí.
And then the next one was the real kicker.
La que sigue es la más mejor.
Do you promise to serve God to the best of your ability all the remaining days of your life?
¿Prometes de seguir al Señor, a cumplir sus promesas hasta el fin de tu vida?
Amen. And yes. We all said yes, otherwise we wouldn't have been baptized.
Y todos dijimos que sí, si no, no fuéramos sido bautizados.
And they walked us into the water. The minister walked us in. And having that authority given of Jesus Christ, we were baptized. Our sins were forgiven because God said, if you do that, I promise to forgive you.
Y el ministro nos llevó a las aguas adentro y nos bautizó y dijo que si nosotros cumplíamos con su promesa, él también iba a cumplir con su promesa que él hizo para nosotros.
We sang a very powerful song earlier today.
Cantamos un cántico muy poderoso más temprano.
¿Por qué él vive?
¿Por qué él vive?
God sent his son.
El Señor mandó su hijo.
Why?
Porque él eso era lo que iba a hacer.
He lived and died to buy my pardon.
Él vivió y murió.
Why? Because he promised he would.
Que eso era lo que iba a hacer.
And every time I violate God's law and I repent, he forgives me.
Y cada vez que yo no cumplo con mi promesa, que quiebro los mandamientos y le pido perdón.
Why?
Él me perdona.
And why?
¿Y por qué?
Because he promised he would.
Porque él prometió que eso era lo que iba a hacer.
God keeps his promises thousands of years ago and even today.
Dios cumple sus palabras hace miles de años atrás y también hoy.
He said he would set up a church so that his people could come together, share their talents, and help save the world.
Y él prometió que iba a poner una iglesia junta para que cada uno de nosotros compartiéramos nuestros talentos para que creciera la iglesia.
This church is going to be the bride of Christ.
Esta iglesia va a ser la novia de Cristo.
Perfect.
Perfecta.
Holy.
Santa.
Set apart.
Va a ser apartada.
For the to marry the Son of God.
Para casarse con el Hijo de Dios.
Not in a literal sense.
No en literalmente.
But in a way, a spiritual sense, that we will be his people here, now, and forever.
Que vamos a ser su gente espiritualmente hoy, mañana, y para siempre.
And so we're growing together as a body to become that holy bride for our Christ.
Y esto, por eso estamos todos juntos participando para unirnos más para ser esa novia para el Cristo.
Jesus was perfect.
Jesús fue perfecto.
And he deserves a perfect bride.
Y merece una novia perfecta.
And he promised that to Jesus.
Y él le prometió eso a Jesús.
And if he promised it to him, he'll keep that promise.
Y si él le hizo esa promesa a Jesús, él va a cumplir con su promesa.
And brothers and sisters, today, God is keeping that promise a little bit at a time every day.
Hermanos y hermanas, Dios está cumpliendo con esa promesa diariamente.
He's working in our lives to help make us more holy, more righteous, so that we can be the people his son deserves.
Y él está trabajando entre nosotros para que seamos más justos, más santificados, para poder ser esa iglesia para Jesús.
Most importantly,
lo más importante,
when you're in trouble,
cuando estás en problemas,
when you need him,
cuando usted lo necesita,
he's there.
Él está ahí.
He doesn't ignore you until you're perfect.
Él no te ignora hasta que seas perfecto.
He doesn't forget about you while he's working on.
Él no se olvida de ti mientras que él está trabajando en ti.
The reason he's blessing you is because he knows you need him.
Y la razón que él nos está bendiciendo es porque él sabe que nosotros lo necesitamos.
I'm going to let you in on a little secret.
Les voy a decir un secreto.
And I know you're going to find this hard to believe.
Y va a ser difícil para que crean esto.
I'm not perfect.
Yo no soy, hermano Jerry no es perfecto. Ni yo tampoco. Because I was going to say me first.
Oh, okay.
Es que no me iba a incluir yo misma.
I'm not perfect enough yet to be a part of the bride of Christ.
Hermano Jerry dice que él no es suficiente perfecto para ser la novia de Jesús.
But every day he's working on me, molding me, shaping me like a piece of clay on the potter's wheel.
Y cada día él me está componiendo y poniéndome como cuando componen un vaso de how do you say clay, hermano?
You're looking at me?
Clay.
Clay. Oh my gosh.
Hermana?
Barro.
De barro, que así no está él moldeando así en ese modo. I'm sorry.
That's okay. I'll learn not to use that next time.
Right. Don't use hard words. De Dios que no use palabras difíciles para mí.
You see, I'm not perfect. Even here preaching right now, I'm tripping up Sister Mary.
Ya ven, no soy perfecto que aquí le estoy haciendo difícil a la hermana mía.
We have to keep learning. We have to keep growing. We have to leave our heart open so that God can work with us.
Necesitamos dejar nuestro corazón abierto, nuestras mentes abiertas para que el Señor pueda trabajar entre nosotros.
There was a time when I would have been embarrassed to admit that to you.
Hubo un tiempo que fuera sido difícil para admitir eso a ustedes.
But God's been working on me.
Pero Dios está trabajando en él.
It's less of an issue now.
Ya no es tan gran cosa.
We laugh at it because we all have rough edges that God is trying to smooth over.
Y nos podemos reír porque todos el Señor está trabajando en componernos.
And you know why?
¿Y sabes por qué?
You know why he's trying to smooth over those rough edges?
¿Y sabes por qué quiere que seamos más perfectos?
I bet you can guess.
Yo creo que ustedes pueden adivinar.
He promised he would.
Él prometió que lo iba a hacer.
He loved you the way you were the day you walked into the waters, but he promised you, I'm not going to leave you that way.
Él hizo esa promesa cuando usted entró a las aguas del bautismo y cuando él salió, él prometió que no nos iba a dejar y iba a cumplir su promesa.
He took a piece of coal and he started to shape it and mold it and he's going to make it a diamond for his honor and glory.
Y tomó un pedazo de donde se hacen las diamantes y nos va a hacer perfectos para ser perfectos para él.
That's been his promise since day one.
Eso ha sido su promesa desde el primer día.
And he is working on that promise through every generation.
y Él está trabajando en esa promesa en cada generación.
Brothers and sisters, today I want you to understand that God has been making promises for thousands of years.
Hermanos y hermanas, yo quiero que comprendan que Dios está haciendo promesas de miles y millones de años atrás.
And He hasn't broken one.
Y Él no ha rompido ni una.
And while they may still be in the process of being fulfilled, He's still busy at work because He knows that everybody's soul salvation depends on it.
Y aunque todavía están, no todo está completo, Él sigue trabajando en cada uno de nosotros porque todavía hay tiempo para hacer esa perfección.
And no promise is more important to Him than the one that said, I want to save your soul.
Y no hay una promesa más grande que la que hizo de que Él quiere salvar tu alma.
I have sent my son to help you.
Yo he mandado a mi hijo para salvarte.
So it doesn't have to be your righteousness, it's His that I'll be looking at.
Y no va a ser que yo va a ver lo que justo tú eres, va a ver lo justo que Él es.
I'm going to send you my spirit.
Voy a mandar mi espíritu.
So that it's not your thoughts that are trying to guide your footsteps, it'll be my thoughts trying to guide them.
Y no van a ser tus pensamientos que te van a guiar, pero van a ser mis pensamientos que te van a guiar.
And I've made promises to a whole group of people that I need your help to fulfill.
Y yo he hecho muchas promesas a muchas gentes y los necesito a ustedes para cumplir estas promesas.
Because there is coming a day when I, God, am going to be so tired of the filth that I see on this land that I'm going to wipe it clean and start over with a promised people.
Y un día me voy a cansar de toda esta suciedad y lo voy a terminar todo para comenzar de nuevo con mi gente escogida.
Because I made a promise to Joseph thousands of years ago that I'm still in the process of keeping.
Porque le hice una promesa a José millones de años atrás y todavía la tengo que cumplir.
And yes, as God, I could do it all by myself. I don't need your help.
Y yo siendo Dios, lo puedo hacer sin la ayuda de ustedes.
But as God, I want your help.
Pero como soy Dios, yo quiero que me ayuden.
Because if you help me, then you will share in my joy.
Porque si ustedes me ayudan a mí, van a ayudarme en mi gozo.
When you see my people coming together, when you see a holy nation rising up, then you'll know you shared in that joy.
Y cuando ustedes vean esta gente reunida, una nación grande, perfecta y bendecida, es el trabajo y la promesa de Dios.
And He has promised that if you endure to the end, there is a place waiting for you in glory that no words in this human language can explain.
Y si ustedes duran hasta el fin, Él les va a tener un lugar que Él les ha prometido que no hay palabras para explicarlo.
So today, brothers and sisters and friends, I want you to think about how faithful God has been to keeping His promises.
Hoy en este día, hermanos, hermanas y amigos, quiero que pongan atención en la gran promesa que Dios nos ha hecho.
He is in the business of keeping promises.
Él está en el negocio de cumplir sus promesas.
And He would love to keep a very special one with you.
Y Él quisiera tener una muy especialmente con usted.
If you let me in, I promise I'll make you better.
Si tú me dejas entrar, yo te voy a hacer tu vida mejor.
Do you believe me?
¿Me creen? Amén.
Look, you don't have to if you don't want to.
Si usted no quiere creer, no tiene que.
It's in here.
Está aquí. I don't know why.
I'm holding up the Bible and the book of Mormon.
Está deteniendo los libros, el libro de Mormón y la Biblia.
You don't have to believe me. You can read it for yourself.
No le necesitan creer al hermano Jerry. Ustedes lo pueden leer por sí mismo.
I'm just trying to save you a little time.
Yo nomás les quiero quitar un poquito de tiempo.
Give your heart to the Lord and see how He'll keep His promises to bless your life.
Denle su corazón al Señor y verán cómo Él cumple sus promesas con usted.
May God bless you is my prayer.
Que el Señor los bendiga, es mi oración.
Hello, Sister Mary.
Hola, hermano Juan.
Brother Jerry talked about promises.
Hermano Jerry habló de promesas.
Talked about sin.
Habló de pecado.
Brother Jerry, when you said that we make a promise for God to forgive us of our sins, we're supposed to ask him to forgive us of all sin, correct?
El hermano Juan le está preguntando a Brother Jerry que si él quiso decir que el Señor quería perdonarnos de todos nuestros pecados, que eran todos los pecados, y es verdad.
So we need to make that promise that God's going to forgive us of all our sins, correct?
Tenemos que creer que el Señor nos va a cumplir esa promesa, ¿verdad?
Many years ago, when we first started ministering in Fort Worth.
Muchos años atrás, cuando comenzamos a hacer el ministro aquí en Fort Worth.
This is way before I was a minister.
Esta era fue antes que yo fuera un ministro.
I want to share a little story with you.
Quiero compartirles una historia.
There was a sister that we had in the church, Sister Dora.
Teníamos una hermana que se llamaba Sister Dora.
Sister Dora was a, how would I like to put this, a very different person. Go ahead.
La hermana Dora era una hermana muy
diferente.
Diferente.
A lot of faith, this woman.
Tenía mucha fe.
Sometimes the way she would talk to people was a little abrupt.
En veces a la gente que le hablaba les hablaba un poco duro.
If you were having some problems, she would tell you, "Well, what's wrong with you?"
Y si tú le decías que tenías un problema, le dice, "Pues qué te pasa a ti?"
And she would say it in that manner, like, "What's wrong with you? Don't you know what you need to do?"
Y así les hablaba, ¿qué te pasa? Porque no sabes qué hacer.
And they would look at her and she'd say, you need to trust God.
Les decía, tiene que confiar en Dios.
And she would testify to people about the good things that God could do for you.
Y ella testificaba de las buenas cosas que el Señor puede hacer para ustedes.
She was different.
Ella era diferente.
She was at times sweet.
En veces era muy amable.
At times she was, like I said, very rough and straightened to the point.
Y a veces era muy dura y te decía las cosas directamente.
Back then, Brother Jeff and Brother Joe were the ministers of our church that were here.
En ese tiempo, el hermano Joe y el hermano Jeff eran los ministros en ese tiempo.
And every now and then, when our brothers would need to speak to somebody that didn't speak English and only spoke Spanish.
Cuando ellos tenían que hablar con gente que no hablaban español, no hablaban inglés, nomás español.
The brothers would ask me to help translate whatever the point they wanted to make or the discussion they wanted to have with the individual.
Y le pedían a hermano Juan que él viniera y hablara, trasladara las palabras de que le querían decir a la gente.
One evening, we're at Brother Joe's house, I believe, a couple of us there, having dinner, and we were there sitting down talking, having conversation, and the phone rings.
Una noche, una tarde, estábamos en la casa de Brother Joe, cenando, platicando, y de repente suena el teléfono.
It's Sister Dora.
Es la hermana Dora.
And she tells Brother Jeff that she's been talking to Jose and been telling him that he needs to turn his life around.
Y dice que le dijo al hermano Jeff que ella estaba platicando con Jose y que le estaba diciendo que él tenía que cambiar su vida.
This individual, Jose, he was an alcoholic and he had to have some kind of beer every day.
Esta persona, Jose, era un alcohólico y tenía siempre que traer una cerveza en su mano.
The way the story goes for Jose, he said that he had this addiction of alcohol so bad that when he walked down an alley, he would see these empty beer cans that maybe had been sitting there all day. He would pick them up and try to drink the last one or two drops that may be in the can.
Él tenía tan mal el alcoholismo que cuando iba por el callejón y si miraba botes de cerveza, los tomaba a ver si tenían una última gota de cerveza.
Whatever empty can there was, he would pick it up.
Cualquier bote que él encontraba vacío, él lo levantaba.
He told Sister Dora, "There's no way God can help me with this."
Y él le dijo a la hermana Dora, "No hay ninguna forma que Dios me pueda ayudar con esto."
He told Dora, "I have been an alcoholic for years."
Y él le dijo a la hermana Dora, yo he sido alcohólico por muchos años.
Now, I don't know what his age was, but he was an older gentleman, maybe I would say maybe 45, 50, maybe.
That's old, okay.
Not anymore, 65.
El hermano dice que no está seguro cuántos años tenía este hombre, pero tenía como 40, 45 años de edad.
And he'd been having this disease all his life of drinking alcohol.
Y tenía esta enfermedad de tomar alcohólico mucho de su vida.
Sister Dora said to him, I promise you, I guarantee you, if you get baptized, if you turn your life around, God will heal you.
Hermana Dora le dijo, yo te prometo y te lo juro que si tú te bautizas, el Señor puede cambiar tu vida.
He wanted to do this. He wanted to make this change in his life.
Y él sí quería cambiar su vida.
He didn't want to live that way anymore.
Ya no quería vivir en esa vida.
But all he thought was, I can't be a baptized member of your church. I can't be a brother in Christ like you're asking me to, Sister Dora, because this disease just has a hold of me.
Y él le dijo a la hermana Dora, yo no puedo bautizarme y ser miembro de esta iglesia porque esta enfermedad es muy, muy más que yo.
So the conversation that Brother Jeff was having with Sister Dora about Brother Jose continued on.
Y siguió la plática con hermano Jeff sobre José.
And Sister Dora explained all of this to Brother Jeff about José's situation.
Y hermana Dora le explicó toda la historia de José a hermano Jeff.
And she basically told Brother Jeff and Brother Joe, you have to baptize him.
Y casi les dijo al hermano Joe y al hermano Jeff, tienen que bautizar a este hombre.
The brothers called me over.
Los hermanos llamaron al hermano Juan.
They said, Brother Juan, would you talk to Brother Jose?
Hermano Juan, por favor, hable con hermano Jose.
They said, explain to him the commitment he's making and make him understand that he needs to understand that he's going to ask God to forgive him of all sin, all his sins.
Queremos que le explique a este hombre de lo que se va a comprometer y que tiene que pedir perdón por todos sus pecados, todos sus pecados.
And make him understand or help him understand that this is a commitment he's making to God, not to us as men.
Y tiene que saber comprender que este compromiso no es con nosotros, pero con Dios.
Brother Jeff hands me the phone.
Brother Jeff le dio el teléfono al hermano Juan.
Now, by this point of the story, the three of us are in a separate room by ourselves, away from everybody else.
Y a este punto todos estamos en cuartos separados.
And as I'm talking to the individual in Spanish, to Jose,
y yo, mientras yo hablo en español con Jose,
Brother Joe and Brother Jeff were sitting in front of me.
Brother, el hermano Joe y hermano Jeff están sentados enfrente de mí.
And they're watching my reaction as I talk to Brother Jose.
Están viendo mis reacciones mientras yo hablo con Jose.
In part of my conversation to him, I explained to him what we're asking him to promise or the commitment he's having to make.
Y yo le estaba explicando a él lo que tenía que comprometer a hacer estas promesas.
And then one of the moments that we were talking, I said, do you promise to ask God to forgive you of all the sins?
Y en esa conversación yo le dije a él, ¿prometes de pedirle perdón al Señor de todos tus pecados?
He said, not all of them.
Y él dijo, no todos.
Not all of them, Brother Juan.
No todos, hermano Juan.
When he said that to me, I was like,
y cuando él me dijo eso, yo le dije, ¿qué?
So my reaction, you can imagine the brothers saw my reaction, they're like, uh-oh, this is not good.
Y cuando los hermanos vieron como yo reaccioné, como reaccionó el hermano, dijeron, algo no va bien.
And I tried to understand what he meant, but not all sin.
Y yo estaba tratando de comprender por qué me decía no todos los pecados.
And I said, you have to ask God to forgive you of all sins.
Y yo le dije, tienes que pedirle perdón al Señor por todos tus pecados.
And he says, no.
Y él me dice, no.
And I can hear Dora in the background saying, yes, all sins.
Y puedo oír a hermana Dora diciéndole atrás, sí, tiene que ser todos los pecados.
And he says, no, not all sin.
Y él vuelve y dice, no, no todos los pecados.
I tried to ask it in a different form.
Y entonces yo traté de preguntarle en otra forma.
Again, the response was no.
Y otra vez me contestó, no.
Brothers are looking at me. They can tell this isn't going well.
Y los hermanos me están viendo y están viendo que no están viendo la plática bien.
I then ask him, what do you mean not all sin? Can you help me understand what you mean by not all sin?
Y le dije, dices que no todo el pecado. Hazme entender lo que quieres decir que no todos los pecados.
He said, I'm not going to ask God to forgive me of the big ones.
No le voy a decir al Señor que me perdone de los grandes.
Again, I reacted.
Y otra vez yo reaccioné.
I said, what do you mean? I mean, all sin, small ones, big ones.
Como, y le pregunté yo, tienen que ser todos los grandes y los pequeños.
And I said, what do you mean you will not ask God to forgive you for the big sins?
¿Y por qué le vas a decir al Señor que no quieres que te perdone de los pecados grandes?
He then said to me, I have not committed any big sin.
Y la respuesta fue, yo no he cometido los grandes pecados.
And I asked again, can you tell me what you mean by a big sin?
Y yo le pregunté, ¿qué quieres decir con los grandes pecados?
He said, Bible says, thou shalt not kill.
La Biblia dice, no debes de matar.
He said, I've never killed.
Yo no he matado a nadie.
Why would I ask God to forgive me of killing somebody?
¿Por qué le debo de pedir al Señor que me perdone de matar a alguien?
He said, I've never disrespected my parents.
Y él dijo, yo nunca he dejado de respetar a mis padres. Okay.
He says, that's a sin in the Bible, right?
Eso es un pecado en la Biblia, ¿no?
And he told me, he asked me again, he goes, killing is a sin in the Bible, right?
Y me preguntó otra vez, matar es un pecado en la Biblia, ¿verdad?
And I said, yes, it is.
Y le dije, sí, es verdad.
That's when he said, I have not committed those sins.
Yo no he cometido esos pecados, dijo él.
So I asked him once again, I said, will you forgive God of all the sins you have committed?
Would you forgive God?
I said, would you ask God to forgive you of all the sins that you have committed? I asked that to Jose.
Y yo le pregunté a él, ¿le puedes tú preguntar a Dios que si te perdona de todos los pecados que tú has cometido?
That's when he said yes.
Es cuando dijo sí.
When he said yes,
cuando él dijo que sí,
I had a big smile on my face.
Tenía una sonrisa grande en mi cara.
And the brothers knew that everything was going to be okay.
Y los hermanos se dieron cuenta que todo iba a estar bien.
You could say that this was one of those cases that something was lost in translation.
Pueden decir que algo se perdió en la trasladera.
But here's what I want you to understand.
Pero esto es lo que yo quiero que entiendan.
An alcoholic.
Un alcohólico.
Jose, an alcoholic for many years.
Jose era un alcohólico por muchos años.
We went ahead and can't remember if it was the next day or I think it was the following week. We took him to the water to baptize him.
Pienso que la siguiente semana lo llevamos a las aguas para bautizarlo.
When you would first see him, you could see that by the look of his face and his body, he had lived a rough life.
Viéndolo de su cara y su cuerpo, podían ver que había tenido una vida muy difícil.
And if you've known and seen some alcoholics, you could see how it takes a toll on their body and on their complexion and so forth, right?
Y si han visto un alcohólico, pueden ver cómo es su cuerpo, ¿verdad?
The brothers took him in the water.
Los hermanos lo metieron al agua.
They baptized him.
Lo bautizaron.
We returned to the church.
Regresamos a la iglesia.
They bestowed the Holy Ghost on him.
Le pusieron las manos para el Espíritu Santo.
He partake in sacrament.
Compartió con el sacramento.
The next Sunday, he came to church.
El siguiente domingo vino a la iglesia.
His face looked like maybe he was 20 years old.
Y su cara se miraba que tenía la edad de 20 años.
Young individual.
Se miraba como un joven.
It's like there was a light shining behind him. He was like a brilliance behind him.
Había una cosa brillante, una luz detrás de él.
He brought his guitar.
Trajo su guitarra.
He sang a few songs.
Y cantó unos cánticos.
To give honor and glory to God.
Para darle la honra y gloria a Dios.
And he testified that Sunday.
Y testificó ese domingo.
You know what his testimony was?
¿Y saben lo que fue su testimonio?
He said, I used to walk down the alley and pick up all these empty beer cans.
Y dijo, yo caminaba por los callejones y levantaba los botes de cerveza.
I had to pick them up to get that last drop of beer.
porque los tenía que tomar la última gota de la, del bote.
He says, since the day I got baptized,
desde el día que me bauticé,
I walk down the same alleys.
Camino por el mismo callejón.
I see these beer cans in the way.
Y miro los botes de cerveza.
And instead of picking them up,
y en lugar de levantarlos,
I kick them out of my path.
Les doy una patada para que se quiten de mi camino.
I have not had a drop since last Sunday.
No ha tomado ni una gota desde el domingo antepasado.
God healed him.
Dios lo dio su salud.
God healed him of alcoholism.
El Señor lo alivió del alcoholismo.
Dora told him, if you accept Jesus Christ, if you accept God and you want to change your life, do these things and your life will be better.
Y hermana Dora le dijo, si tú quieres cambiar tu vida, tener una vida mejor, esto que tienes que hacer.
Brother came to church for several weeks.
El hermano vino varias semanas más.
He kept saying, I drink no more.
Y que seguía diciendo, ya no tomo.
He even said, I don't even have a desire to taste alcohol.
Y dijo, ni tengo el deseo de tomar alcohol.
God changed his life.
Dios cambió su vida.
Unfortunately, he told us he had to move back to Mexico.
Desafortunadamente tuvo que irse para atrás para México.
He had to go back and take care of his family.
Tuvo que irse para cuidar su familia.
But here's what I believe.
Pero esto es lo que yo creo.
I believe today he's still playing his guitar.
Yo creo que todavía en este día está tocando su guitarra.
Singing honor and glory to God.
Cantándole la honra y gloria a Dios.
For the change that he made in his life.
Por el cambio que Dios hizo en su vida.
For asking God to forgive him of his sins.
Por pedirle al Señor que le perdonara sus pecados.
And to be a good servant of God.
Y ser un buen siervo de Dios.
Do you want a change in your life?
¿Usted quiere un cambio en su vida?
Accept Jesus Christ.
Acepta a Jesucristo.
God bless you.
Que el Señor los bendiga.
Just 3 minutes.
No más 3 minutos.
I want to share something with you.
Quiero compartir algo con ustedes.
You were in the church that was established in the days of Adam.
Ustedes están en una iglesia que fue establecida en los días de Adán y Eva.
Adam, his son, and his grandson prayed.
Adán, su hijo, y su nieto oraron.
And the Book of Mormon says God sent an angel to them with the plan of redemption.
Y dice la escritura que Dios mandó un ángel para explicarles el plan de salvación.
This church was not established by a man.
Esta iglesia no fue establecida por un hombre.
It was established by God at the beginning of time.
Estuvo establecida por Dios desde el principio de la era.
And the message you received today,
y el mensaje que usted recibió hoy,
was given to the brothers by God.
El mensaje fue dado a los hermanos por Dios.
So we would live our life better in service to Him.
Para que vivamos una vida mejor y darles buen servicio a Dios.
So when somebody asks you where you go to church,
así que cuando alguien le pregunte a dónde va, a qué iglesia va,
and I want to tell you,
y yo les quiero decir,
when you understand that this was established with Adam, Seth, and Enos,
cuando
at
ustedes,
the beginning of time,
ustedes saben que esta iglesia fue establecida
ya
también. Tienen algo que ha sido eternamente.
You're part of something that was established by the Word of God.
Fue algo que está establecido por la palabra de Dios.
And he waited for you to accept his call.
Y esperó a que usted hicieran su llamada a Dios.
And for that, you have the blessings of God.
Y ahora tienen las bendiciones de Dios.
The love of God.
El amor de Dios.
And eternal life.
Y vida eterna.
So remember the message today.
Recuerden el mensaje de hoy.
May God bless you.
Que el Señor los bendiga.